So I want to talk about an application of logs and including the derivative. And I want to emphasize to you, we've been talking about kind of two main questions that we've been answering using the derivative. And one is, how does some quantity or the function, the output quantity, change at a point? So how is it changing? What's the rate of change? Things like that. We've also looked at using the derivative as an approximation for a one unit difference. So what do I expect for example, when production increases from 10 units to 11 units, right? How does that, and we've looked at why the derivative, this is an application of marginal analysis. That I really don't have to compute these two values, but that the derivative, let's say f of x, approximates this difference when the difference is 1. Okay, so let's talk about this next problem, and the problem that you see. It says the daily cost in dollars for a manufacturer to produce X electronic video components is given by this function. If the manufacturer is currently producing 60 components each day, by how much can the cost be expected to change if production is increased by one component each day to 61? So do you see this question? Asking about changing production from 60 to 61 units. And that's a question for marginal analysis. So I really want to say C prime of 60 approximates this change. Oops, I want C of 61, right? Minus C of 60. I did it again. C of 61 minus C of 60. Okay? So I really am going to find C prime of x. This is my plan. Really? Right? Find C prime of x and plug in 60. Okay. So I go back to C of x, and that's 1000 natural log cubed root of 3x squared minus 700. I don't like that cube root in there, so I'm going to try and simplify that. That's 1000 natural log, and cube root is the same thing as to the 1/3 power, right? Now it's also true with logs that this can come out front, and I can get 1/3 times 1000 times natural log of just this, and that makes my life much simpler. So, and I'll simplify this as just 1000 over 3, natural log of 3x squared minus 700. Okay, so now I want to take the derivative of this piece. So c prime of x is equal to 1000 over 3 sits out front, right? And then this derivative of natural log is 1 over the inside, 3x squared minus 700 times the derivative of the inside, which should just be 6x. Okay? And again, I'm going to move that 6x piece into this numerator. And I think I'm going to multiply these pieces together. See the 1000 times 6x, so I get 6000x over, and multiply this 3 inside to get 9x squared, and the 3 times the 700 minus 2100. So I think it looks something like that. Okay, and now I want to plug in, I mean, now that's my C prime, That's it. Now I want to go ahead and plug in. We said we're going to plug in 60, right? So I'm going to do that. C prime of 60, 6,000 times 60 over 960 squared minus 2,100. So let's see. Let me plug that into my calculator and you guys do the same, okay? Divided by 9x squared. Okay, I think I get about 11.88, but I want to check it one more time. Okay, so I have this number 11.88. Let's take a look. So I want to go back up and interpret this in a sentence. But remember, this 11.88 is what I got for my answer, and I want to go back up and look at the statement again. Okay, so here we are, right here, and now I'm changing this, and how does the cost change? So here I got C prime of 60 is 11.88, right? And so I really expect cost to increase by about $11.88. If I increase production. Production. Okay. Okay, let me know if you have questions.